seen the definition of capacitor, that is C equal to Q upon V. How we can find out the capacitance based on the geometry of the capacitor? Now, in this video, we'll find out the capacitance of the system for parallel plate capacitors. If I know the area of the plate, distance between the two conducting plates, for different types of combinations, we'll find out the capacitors. We call them as composite capacitors. And we'll also find out the expression for the total energy stored in a capacitor. So let us proceed. Now, if we assume a parallel plate capacitor where there are two conducting surfaces, a conducting surface with a charge density of plus rho s, another conducting surface with a charge density of minus rho s, and the separation between these two conductors, its distance d. So plus rho s conductor surface, it is at z equal to 0, and negatively charged conductor surface, it is located at z equal to d. And because of this charge densities, there will be some electric field here. The lines of electric field start at the positive charge and terminate on the negative charge. Now, as per the equations we have studied earlier, the electric field intensity because of a positive charge rho s, it will be oriented in this direction. So this is electric field intensity E1, which is given by equation rho s upon 2 epsilon, and it is directed in the normal direction of this surface. So the normal direction of this surface is the z direction. So it is rho s upon 2 epsilon az. Now, in the same manner, the electric field intensity because of this negative charge density rho s, it is also oriented in the normal direction. So this is minus rho s upon twice epsilon, oriented in the normal direction. So this is minus rho s upon twice epsilon an. But we are interested in finding out the electric field intensity between this space 0 to d. So because of this, the electric field intensity in this direction, because of minus rho s, we call it as E2. So this direction is minus az direction. So the electric field intensity in minus az direction, it is minus az, or this is minus an direction. So the electric field intensity E2, because of surface charge density minus rho s in the space 0 to d, it is given as minus rho s upon twice epsilon into minus az. So this negative negative sign cancels, and it becomes rho s upon twice epsilon az. So adding these two electric field intensities here, E1 plus E2, so that will be the total electric field intensity inside this space. So this is given as rho s upon twice epsilon az plus rho s upon twice epsilon az, and it becomes rho s upon epsilon az. So that is the electric field intensity within the two conducting plates of parallel plate capacitor. Now, based on this, we can find out the potential between these two plates by using the equation E dot dl, line integral E dot dl. Negatively charged plate two positively charged plate, the limits of the integration. So negatively charged plate, it is the upper plate, and positively charged plate is the lower plate. So upper plate, it is located at z equal to d, and the lower plate, it is located at z equal to 0. So putting these limits here, now E, as we have seen, it is rho s upon epsilon az dot dl, it is the differential length in, if we assume, rectangular coordinates, that is dx ax plus dy ay plus dz az. Now the dot product az dot ax, it is 0 because both are perpendicular to each other. Az dot ay, that is also 0 because they are perpendicular, and az dot az, that dot product is 1. So this reduces to rho s upon epsilon dz. Now solving this, we will get potential V between the two plates. Rho s upon epsilon, we can take outside of the integral. So integrating this, z equal to d to z equal to 0. By changing the limits of integration to z equal to 0 to z equal to d, the negative sign, it will cancel with this dz. Then this becomes V equal to rho s d upon epsilon. So this is the expression for potential between two plates for the parallel plate capacitor. Now we substitute V equal to rho s d upon epsilon here. If I know area of the plate as A and rho s is the charge density in coulomb per meter square multiplied by this area in meter square, this gives me the total charge Q on the plate. So rho s from this, it cancels. So finally we get this as epsilon A by D. So that is the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. Now let us take one example. Calculate the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor having mica dielectric. So the material is given as mica and epsilon r is 6, and the plate area A is 10 inch square, and the distance between the two conductors, two plates, it is 0.01 inch. So first let us convert the area which is given in inches into meters. So 10 inch square, after converting into meter square, it is 6.452 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter square. Similarly, converting this D, which is given in inches, to meter, it is 2.54 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter. Now we know the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor, it is epsilon A by D. So substituting, now epsilon is epsilon 0, epsilon r. So epsilon 0 is 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 12, and epsilon r is 6. And A, 6.542 into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by distance 2.54 into 10 raised to minus 4. So calculating this gives me the capacitance of this system as 1.349 nanofarad. Now let us assume a composite parallel plate capacitor where there are two conducting plates, top and bottom, and in between there are two dielectric materials, epsilon 1 and epsilon 2. So the area of both these dielectrics is same. So the thickness of dielectric 1, it is D1, and thickness of dielectric 2, it is D2, and the total thickness D, it is D1 plus D2. So for this type of construction of the parallel plate capacitor, we call it as the composite parallel plate capacitor. So let us find out the capacitance for this type of capacitor. So it is made up of several dielectrics. In this case, we are assuming two dielectrics, but the same concept can be extended further. Now we assume the distance D to be very, very small as compared to the area of the plates. So we assume a charge Q on one plate, and in that case, rho S, that is the charge density, it is nothing but Q upon A for the top and bottom plates. Now, as per boundary conditions, dN1, that is the normal component of electric flux density in region 1, it is equal to normal component of electric flux density in region 2, and that is same as surface charge density. So this was the result of boundary condition we have seen earlier. Because of this, I can say D is nothing but rho S, or that is Q upon A. So substituting this for D, this gives me E1 equal to Q upon epsilon 1 A, and similarly E2, it is Q upon epsilon 2 A. Now, as electric field intensity is E, is V by D, volts per meter. So we can write V1 for region 1 as E1 into D, similarly V2 equal to E2 into D. So if this voltage is V1, this voltage is V2, then the total voltage across these two plates, that is nothing but V1 plus V2. So it is Q upon V1 plus V2. So substituting this value of V1 and V2 in this expression for C, we can write this as Q upon V1 is now E1 D1 E1 D1 plus E2 D2. Now E we write in terms of D. So E1 is nothing but D1 upon epsilon 1 into D1 plus, writing E2 in terms of D2. So this is D2 upon epsilon 2 into small D2, that is the thickness of second region. Now we know rho S is equal to D1 equal to D2. So this equation, we write it as C equal to Q upon rho S. Now D1 we substitute as rho 1. So this is rho S D1 upon epsilon 1 plus rho S D2 upon epsilon 2. Now the charge Q is nothing but rho S into A. charge q, it is the surface charge density multiplied by area. So this is rho s upon rho s into a. So in the denominator I take common as rho s, so this is d1 upon epsilon 1 plus d2 upon epsilon 2. So from this rho s cancels, and dividing both sides by a gives me c as 1 upon d1 upon epsilon 1 a plus d2 upon epsilon 2 a. Now for a parallel plate capacitor, c is equal to epsilon a by d, d upon epsilon a is nothing but 1 upon c. So using this relationship here, d1 upon epsilon 1 a is nothing but 1 upon c1, and d2 upon epsilon 2 a is nothing but 1 upon c2. So this gives me c equal to 1 upon c1 plus 1 upon c2. This is the capacitance of the system for a composite capacitor made up of two dielectrics with permittivity epsilon 1 and epsilon 2. Now let us assume another composite capacitor with different geometry. There is a top conducting plate with area A and the bottom conducting plate with area A. Now this region 1 and region 2, these are separated by a vertical separation. So this is a dielectric with permittivity epsilon 1. This is the second dielectric with permittivity epsilon 2. So for such type of composite capacitor, let us find out the equivalent capacitors. Now from boundary conditions, we know rho s1, that is the surface charge density, it is same as d1, and d1 is epsilon 1 e1. So from this we can write d1 as epsilon 1 v by d, because e is equal to voltage divided by distance, v by d. Similarly, for the second region, rho s2 equal to d2 equal to epsilon 2 e2, and d2 is epsilon 2 v upon d. Assuming a charge q on the plate, now the total charge is q1 plus q2. Q1 is the charge along this region 1, and q2, it is the charge in the region 2. So the total charge q is nothing but q1 plus q2. This is q1 plus q2. Now this area is a1 and this area is a2. So charge on the area a1 is surface charge density rho s1 into a1, and charge on this side of the plate, this is rho s2, that is the surface charge density multiplied by this area. So that is the total charge. So q is equal to rho s1 a1 plus rho s2 a2. And as per boundary conditions, rho s1, it is equal to d1, and rho s2, it is equal to d2. Now d1 is epsilon 1 v divided by d. Substituting this here, similarly d2, epsilon 2 v, substituting here. Now rearranging this equation, the capacitance C is equal to Q upon V. So dividing both sides by V, we get this as epsilon 1 A1 plus epsilon 2 V2. Now we know epsilon A by D, it is C. So this first part, it is C1, and the second part is C2. So the equivalent capacitance of this system is C1 plus C2. Now let us find out the expression for total energy stored in the capacitor. The energy stored in the capacitor is given by this expression, WE equal to 1 by 2 volume integral dot product of D and E. So substituting D equal to epsilon E here, it is epsilon E dot E. Now E dot E, it is E square. So this expression becomes 1 by 2 volume integral epsilon E square dV, substituting E equal to rho s upon epsilon, because D is equal to epsilon E, and as per boundary conditions, this is same as charge density rho s. So from this, E is equal to rho s upon epsilon. So substituting this here, this is rho s upon epsilon square dV. Now evaluating this volume integral as area into distance. So 0 to A area, and over the distance 0 to D. Now one epsilon, it cancels with this epsilon square. So that's why this is rho s square upon epsilon. So this is 1 by 2 rho s square upon epsilon, which can be brought outside of the integral. So this is integral 0 to A integral 0 to D dz dA. So this gives me A into D. This is 1 by 2 rho s square upon epsilon A D. Multiplying both sides by epsilon D, we can write this as 1 by 2 rho s square into D square upon epsilon square multiplied by A upon D multiplied by epsilon. So this is 1 by 2 epsilon A by D rho s square upon epsilon square D square. Now epsilon A by D, this is C. So substituting here epsilon A by D as C, and rho s upon epsilon into D as V. So this becomes the energy stored is WE equal to 1 by 2 CV square or if I substitute C equal to Q upon V, then it is 1 by 2 QV. So this was about the parallel plate capacitors and the composite capacitors and the total energy stored in the capacitors.